President Trump said that if the G7 had been held at his resort in Doral, Florida, it would have been free. What on earth is he talking about? That was no one ever said anything about he would pick up the expenses for it. That's made up.
Yeah, the chief of staff, acting chief of staff, Mick Mulvaney, had a long press conference last week where he said that it would be done at cost. He said nothing about it being free. It was not part of the talking points from the White House as they were trying to defend this over the 48 hours that it was a thing. And then after it became not a thing and the president pulled it back, he said, oh, I would have done it for free. So there's some sort of revisionist history here where the president's trying to make it look better than it would otherwise. And Republicans were the ones that really caused this to be pulled back. It wasn't Democrats. It wasn't the media, as the president said. But over the weekend, he talked to a lot of Republicans who said this is not a good idea, not only the constitutional problems with the emoluments clause, but also politically, it doesn't look good to have the president basically awarding himself a federal contract. It's very easy for Democrats or anyone to put this to the public and say, this does not look good. The president is awarding his own hotel this government contract and having foreign leaders pay to stay at his hotel. It's a very easy argument to make for Democrats, and that's why Republicans were like, let's go a different route.
Yeah, this stinks. Exactly. And Kerry, the president went on a bit of a rant about Doral, and he mentioned the Constitution. A specific clause, a very, very real clause. I want you to take a listen.
I don't run my business. I actually put all the stuff in trusts. They run my, and I didn't have to do that, but under no obligation to do it. I don't think you people with this phony emoluments clause, and by the way, I would say that it's cost me anywhere from $2 to $5 billion to be president.
Yeah, we have absolutely no idea where he gets that number from, and of course, we have no idea what his tax returns look like, because for the first time since the 70s, he hasn't released them. But that said, I want to focus on this phrase, this phony emoluments clause. That's not a phony clause, but why don't you, and the president sometimes watches cable news, I believe. Why don't you try to explain what the emoluments clause is?
Sure. So this is the Constitution. And in the Constitution, there are two different references to emoluments. Emoluments means fee or compensation. And there's one part of the Constitution that talks about domestic emoluments, which means that he can't accept an emolument or a fee from the United States government or from the states. And then there's a second part in the emoluments clause, which talks about foreign emoluments. And that means that as president, he can't receive a fee or emoluments from a king or a foreign government or a foreign state. And they're both in the Constitution. It's not phony. It's right here.
And just not to put too fine a point on it, but the fact of the matter is, he's violating these every day because people are staying in his hotels. One of the unspoken parts of that rough transcript with the president of Ukraine is when the president of Ukraine says, hey, I stayed at one of your hotels.
That's great.
I mean, that was the least of the crimes in that thing. But I mean, this is something that the president violates every time. Poor Jimmy Carter had to sell his peanut farm.
Yeah, I mean, first of all, who doesn't love a girl who carries a pocket constitution? Props to Kerry right here. But what's amazing about this is that it shows Republicans can have influence over the president when they choose to exercise that power. He still has an emoluments problem that needs to be dealt with, but this reminds me somewhat of the Access Hollywood tape when Donald Trump's nomination was really in trouble and Republicans were ready to possibly abandon him. And they essentially forced him to go to the camera and issue that weird apology. Yeah. Donald Trump gets backed into a corner sometimes. And so I hope Republicans who realize that the president presents political problems for them understand that if they speak out in truth when they're right on constitutional issues, they can force him to take a better course.